Yo. Da 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 da.
Easy way or the hard way. And if I'm going to be able to be forced to make a decision here tonight, I'd like your definition of what the easy way and what the hard way is. What is your definition of that?
It's real simple. The easy way is to learn to be flexible, to learn to adapt, Mr. Austin. And if you'd bear with me for just a moment, please. Mr. Austin, adaptation is a key of life as well as in business. That's the easy way, and quite frankly, the hard way. You're going to wind up doing it my way anyhow. You'll be forced into doing it my way, so that's the hard way. And we don't even need to discuss that.
Wow.
Like I said, that's an extremely important decision in my book. For yours and my relationship, can I have maybe 10 seconds to think about this decision?
By all means.
Yeah. What's poppin', everybody? Can y'all hear me? I'm dead. Nigga, I'm gone. Like, I am fucking gone. What's going on, though, motherfuckers?
Like, how you be mad with people that are trying to expose from you? Like, I'm just, you know.
Why the fuck am I streaming?
I'm sure. How is that border
coming? I don't even remember what I did tonight, bro.
Hey.
Shit hard.
Yo. Yo.
He killed this. Might be time for me to start double timing again, bro. Cause I could body this flow.
Rice in my pocket, a lesson pass without the lily. Smoking presidential, like the name of it is Hillary.
My bro, she said that she feel my energy. Ooh, with my dick, yeah. Then she kung fu grip, that. No, huh, rocket like slip, not creeping higher than my wrist. Watch, no rumble, huh, no rumble. Like rumble, like rumble, like rumble.
Hmm. What's this? That's crazy. You're not gonna do my man's like this. That's crazy. You are not gonna do a little yachty like that. That's OD. That's crazy.
Who you coming at, white
boy? I got conceited. You ain't got no legs.
Well, ooh. Soon, with that nose, I'll send your ass to heaven.
Come here. You work for a hair company.
Ooh.
We all know your name is Emmanuel.
I don't know what's going on.
DJ D-Rex, you gonna give him a bell, and I like that. See, this right here is a Kit Kat.
Chico, you know that I am known to rhyme, and I just want to say that.
We've heard you rhyme for a few years, and what you... I saw what you did to Chance with the chocolate. It wasn't a sick rap. I just killed you with chocolate.
Ooh.
Nick, it's really just time for you to stand up. When you do your stand up, nobody stands up. When you do a track, nobody stands up. They don't put their hands up when you stand up. You wore shorts because Mariah stands up. Battle rapping is obviously not your thing, Nick. You should probably stop pushing music. I think the reason why you got the team's gold and platinum is because your albums couldn't do it.
Left off bamboo.
That's crazy. Got left off bamboo.
What's up, guys? I'm Gabby Wilson for MTV News, and I'm here with Logic.
I'm biracial.
Yeah, definitely. Talk to me about...
Yo, there's a lot of people around us.
Yeah. One of the things that I personally was drawn to, because I'm also mixed, this weird thing happens where you sort of feel conflicted about it, right? You're not really sure, like, what your identity is.
Dude, it's hard, because everybody in my family's white, and I'm the only one who looks black, obviously, with my mom.
Wait, what?
Everybody in my family's white, and I'm the only one who looks black.
I'm done. This is what Logic thinks he looks like. Oh, my gosh. This is what Logic thinks he looks like. Oh my gosh.
Obviously with my mom. And yeah. But the thing is, I never talked about it. Being black and white and looking black as hell. And it's hard. And they're like, he's always bringing it up. He's always talking about it. But you know, the truth is I'm proud to be black. I'm not ashamed to be white. I'm biracial. I'm mixed. It is what it is. And I, you know, dropped 6 figures on a tour bus and did a fan tour where I literally went to my fans' houses and ate their family. And I think that's a really cool thing that allows me to connect with a lot of people. Because like, everybody wants to tell you who you are, what you are, where you should fit in, or what you should do. And it's like, no,
I'm biracial.
Now you know, so at least hate me for that. Because honestly, and not to like go on, but yeah, in mainstream media, it's like something that we don't talk about because everybody's got to be white.
Huh?
Well, I'm black and white. And I've never discussed my race, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Well, on top of performing this song, you're also nominated for Best Feat.
No, girl, you know how I do it. Yo, this is a good-ass interview.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, dog, thank you. Oh, my God. It's nice to sit down with somebody who actually knows their shit. You know, I always hate when you sit down with somebody and they're like,
biracial.
Come away with me. Let me take you from this world.
I'm going to tell y'all right now, that's the best part of Logic's album right there. That part is so hard. That part is so hard, bro. come away with me. That shit is, I gotta play it. That shit is so hard. He ain't even sing it though. It was this other dude that was on his shit that sang it. Where is it? This shit, hold on. Killing spree, all the things they wanted me to be. It's everything that I like.
Oh, I know it's hard. Like, I know that's the reason you turn up at night. Living your life, just living your life. Can't nobody tell you how to do it right. Come away with me, come away with me. Let me take you from this world of insanity. Come away.
Everybody say hi, Freya.
Well, I'm black and white, and I've never discussed my race. You know what I'm saying? So,
basically, this whole song is about.
I dig the matching septums. It was my idea.
You didn't have an idea.
Nah, she always wanted one. I just happen to have one. What's this nigga doing?
Basically, this whole song is about cheating on a girl.
Turning off the fan because I got cold. Oh, I forgot this. Why did Tommy these were here? There's probably ants and shit in there.
Nah. Window been closed and it was folded up.
Yeah, basically. I wanted you to watch this.
Camera.
Come a second and make sure you
don't think. This whole song is about cheating on a girl.
Why he just smacking though? Why he just smacking?
My friend was talking to me about like cheating on a girl. I was like, my friend, why are you talking to me? And then I thought about that a little more, but like it was inspired by cheating on a girl. Nah, I'm just kidding. I'm very loyal, very loyal.
Am I tripping?
Males in general are pretty,
what up, Young Taku?
Pretty hasty, including myself. That's the mindset of a lot of males when cheating on a girl. Dudes are only gonna hit a girl up when they need to nut. They'll say anything they want when they need to nut. So, you know, they're being very impatient. You know, I don't wanna waste my time if I get a nut going. You really shouldn't think about God if she can't see where you hide. This other girl is not gonna know about it. If I'm doing all this shit, then how do I know when they need to nut? Either girls I'm talking to, they need to nut. People are just shitty in general. You know, they're being very impatient. You know, I don't want to waste my time if I get a nut gone. You know what I mean? But like, they're both so like afraid of the other girl finding out that in this case, she might as well be God. And if the stars collide, will she relieve my soul? If it works out between me and you, maybe the original chick will get a nut gone. One bad chick in a kitchen full of
dough. Three bad bitches with a hands on a stove. Why he look like Filthy Frank? Wait, what's this? Go back. Go forward. Click home. What's this?
If you wanted to, these expensive, these is red bottoms, these is bloody shoes. Hit the school, I can get them both, I don't bloody shoes. Then I'm quick, cut a nigga off, so don't get bloody shoes. Look, I don't dance now, I make bloody shoes. Say I don't gotta dance, I make bloody shoes. If I see you now and speak, that means I don't bloody shoes. I'm a boss to a worker, bitch, I make bloody shoes.
She kick me out of life, bro. Ay, that bitch don't wanna be friends. Ay, I give her this, she a man. Ay, she put her 10 on my dick. Ay,
Look at my wrist about 10, ayy. Just got a pound of the booth, ayy. Bought that shit straight to the booth, ayy. Tell me my health is a booth, ayy. She said one fuck, bitch, I boof, ayy. You put a gun on my mask, ayy. I put a hole in your booth, ayy. I just got lean on my booth, ayy. I got a Uzi, no Uzi.
Real all these niggas, I might overlap them. Never mind, I done my cap them. Just like a taser, I zap them. Shot, I fuck a bitch in the fart. My diamond shining in the fart. We did that smoke like a fart. I'ma go just like a fart. You police, don't call you Paul. Fart, try but you never get fucked. My dot, formerly rock on my fart.
Okay, hey. Go for long
with that.
Oh, I spy with my little eyes. I spy with my little eyes. She said she 21, I might have to ID that. All my bitches come in pairs like balls in my nutsack. I remember riding around the city in my nutsack, looking for a problem with my young nutsack. I'ma send them all to home with my nutsack.
I'm on my night job, y'all niggas jiving, I'm back up in position. I'ma get.
Let's talk about getting high for a second.
Oh shit.
Nah. Do you have a horror high story, a bad experience while you were high?
Oh shit.
We make me paranoid. Yeah, see my bone broke, so my collarbone, my neck, my hand, and my finger. I felt it. My soul came out of my body, and I was watching myself. I felt it.
Now what was
nigga,
the
recovery? Nigga, I'm lost. This shit is crazy.
It was good.
Now how long did it take for you to recover?
Probably about 6. But yeah. I'm skinny as fuck, so it was just a miracle, I guess.
Do's and don'ts for a speedy recovery.
Listen to your doctors, go to therapy. Because I got like partners who could be walking if they went to therapy, you know what I'm saying? But you got to listen to them doctors because they go to therapy. So just listen to the doctors. Go to therapy.
What just happened?
Now, I noticed you smoke a lot.
Who is this Hawaiian Punch looking nigga? What'd he say?
Now, I noticed you smoke a lot.
Nah.
Favorite strain to smoke?
Pink Lemonade.
Do you remember the first time you ever smoked, ever?
Nah.
Take us back. What was that experience like?
I felt like I ain't even deserve to like be on Earth.
Wow. Do you have a horror high story, a bad experience while you were high?
It's weird shit, bro. Sweating all the time and shit. Sweating all the time and shit. I mean, that's why you get sick, low-key.
This nigga look like a creative player?
Sweating all the time and shit.
This nigga look like a creative character? That don't get used because the nigga that's making them still gotta unlock the rest of the shit. So he don't got none of the premium clothes and the premium tattoos and the premium hair. He just some stock creative player that look fucked up.
That shit crazy, bro. But I stopped myself from doing that shit. I went to Jamba Juice every day. I started getting little smoothies and shit. I'm starting to get into them little snack chips and the motherfucking snack wraps and the motherfucking smoothies and shit.
Look at all these shopping bags.
He seemed lost, so I snuck him home. When my parents were too busy to notice. I kept him fed and in water. He had been traveling the universe in search of his father. He told me of his latest adventures on a planet so cool, it makes you drool. Bars. He said I too could go to Planet Drool someday. Then one night, I was visited by a glowing light. An amazing girl with purple flames for hair. She smiled at me. She told me she needed to return to Planet Drool with her, for a great crisis was developing. I haven't seen
Lil Pop
since then. And that's what I did this summer.
Why they body him like that?
If it's true, why don't you bring
Lil Pop
class tomorrow?
Okay.
Nell is just a government creation. Nell is just a government creation. And all the information they solicit is near the closer truth that was clear since the alteration. But the books that children study when they said Columbus discovered America, oh, the ultimatum. I'm telling you the truth, but oh, well, I'm already in hell. I'm tired of having patience. So I'ma sell my soul and say some shit that fucking bothers you. Jesus wasn't white nor black, I can't knock it. Was somewhat an Arab and one hell of a prophet. Don't understand why J. Cole talking about false prophets. But didn't mention higher ups changing name to Amber Code. These fucking entertainers is playing it by the rules. Sucking government dick for sake to stay cool. I'm absolutely disgusted about all of you motherfuckers. Tie your throat to a truck bed and pedal the metal quickly.
What? Wait, whoa, what? What is happening?
And do do loot do
do do.
Yeah. I don't.
Is there any way you can me?
I don't give a buzz, bro.
There he is.
Be Kizzle, 13 months. Appreciate you.
Wait,
what?
Is there any way you can me?
Oh shit! I didn't put y'all on. Hold on. Okay, peep game, y'all, look. Hold on, I gotta put the fucking... Yeah, hold on, wait, I gotta put y'all niggas on real quick. Hold on. Copy, cancel, chilling cam. Hold on. Add. Browser source. BitBoss. So, peep game. For y'all niggas that wanna use bits and shit, right? Peep game. See this shit right here? When y'all donate bits, the person who attacks the boss last gets their name up on the screen until they get defeated. They can use bits to heal themselves, or y'all can use bits to kill them, and y'all keep y'all name up there. So it's a constant fight. Right now, B Kizzle and resubs and shit counts towards doing damage. B Kizzle right now is the bit boss. So y'all niggas could donate bits to fucking smoke him. And B-Kizzle can donate bits to heal himself and shit. So it's just a matter of who trying to stay the boss.
What's up, bro?
There he is.
Thank you so much.
Ooh, thought you'd never go.
Do you mind if we listen to some music?
Yeah, B-Kizzle, yeah. You're the boss right now.
All right.
You see your name?
Big tune.
That's a jam.
You're full on now, right?
I've been trying to, you know, stay away from.
How's that going?
Not so well, but I like.
Would I be able to show you my? I'm gonna pull in here, and you just show me what you think I've got. Hang on, whereabouts?
So we're trying to beat B-Kizzle's ass.
Do you keep it clean? Do you look after it?
Let's spit shine this guy.
Let's try it with some music.
First, okay. There you go. Turn to the side.
Oh.
Yes.
Ooh.
Take the bossy hands out.
Right. Quick selfie. Oh, it's beautiful. Okay. It's actually an incredible photo.
Ooh. Swag.
Yeah, but again, look, my arms are already going.
It's like you're pushing water away.
Oh, yeah, I'm pushing water
pushing
away.
Pushing water
oh, yeah.
away.
What? That was a solid workout
That's
for me.
Cool, right?
That's the most exercise I've done in years.
Job well done. I had no idea when I got in your car that I'd end up in my
in your own. This is the beauty of it.
Anywho, B-Kizzle is the current target. Go ahead and beat that nigga's ass with some bits.
You know, we do our show every night from Hollywood Boulevard. Well, this is what happens when 50 Cent is standing right behind you.
Outdoor Living magazine just named 50 Cent the greatest rapper of all time. Do you agree with that?
Disagree entirely.
Hell.
I really like his music. I'm very inspired by 50.
Well, why don't you tell him?
I don't know what you heard about me.
50 Cent, man, I think... Holy Kendrick Lamar is...
You are getting another chance.
He's so mad.
Reader's Digest just named 50 Cent the greatest rapper of all time. Well...
Whoa!
50 Cent's best days are behind him and he's pretty washed up.
Yes, I think he's moved on to other, you know, aspects of things, other businesses. Who is this? Wow.
I'm not mad at that.
Yo, Fifth. First off, I want to say happy birthday. Secondly, I want to remind you of the verse you did that made me want to quit rapping.
Picture a perfect picture. Picture me in a pimp hat. Picture me starting shit. Picture me busting my gat. Picture police mad they ain't got a picture of that. Picture me being broke. Picture me smoking a stack. Picture me coming up. Picture me rich from rap. Picture me blowing up. Now picture me going back to my mama basement to live shit. Picture that.
Yeah, so that made me want to stop rapping for like a long time. Anyways, man, happy birthday. Love you, homie. Peace.
What just happened?
Hey everyone, Kendrick Fantano here, and it's time for a review of the new Kendrick Lamar.
Awesome.
Lately, Kendrick has
a nice smooth butt.
He is just great. I also should mention that we do have incredible commercial success and artistic success. Like, Kendrick gives us
God, without a doubt.
And everybody knows it. But before I get too deep into Kendrick, I genuinely think Kendrick is emotionally raw and
thick.
And
it just sounds
creative. But it's nice to kind of hear him put at least a couple of black people in a black turtleneck. And, you know, that's one of the best things about Kendrick. You know, he's beauty standards, amongst other things.
And I'm getting the sense that
I can't believe this shit. I can't believe what's happening right now. It
doesn't seem like he's
there's so much happening and my brain can't register.
Moving on from there, instantly what hits me, Kendrick, you know, he's pretty cool. You guys know the business by now.
And he's pretty thick and
a little sexier because
he is just so bam. And I'm continuing to, you know,
I don't know what else to say other than, again, I'm loving it. Boy.
And Kendrick, you're the best.
And so
thick. I'm feeling a 10.
Okay.
Yeah, nigga. Why is Lil Uzi Vert stapling? Why is Fab doing this? You don't watch me on Twitch. Or really.
I've seen your last 3 Twitches with them fucking bum ass escorts.
What are you yelling about? I never said that you don't talk about music.
Now we got a topic. Want to talk about it?
Y'all not informed on what I talk about.
Do talk about people's personal lives. That's not music.
No, that's a no. So you
I'm
can't
sitting
break
on this.
Why did they put that sound
that's
effect?
A no. So you
I'm
can't
sitting
break
on this. I'm sitting break on this.
Don't wait.
Let's talk.
Jesus Christ.
Hey, I watch every fucking thing you do. You want to talk about it?
Nigga, cut it. Stop.
Don't cut shit. So what you're saying here is, stay woke.
Everybody calm the fuck down.
Atlantic Records have sent me takedown.
Wait, you very rarely talk about music.
No, shut the fuck up, both of you.
Every day.
I don't know how to put the mic.
Every Thursday, come up at the... Y'all wouldn't even know I did music reviews.
Oh, where did he find a staple gun? I don't really care if you're
a guy. Where did he find a staple gun, though?
No. I don't know what is going on. Hey! First of all, I ain't seen a staple gun in 30 years.
And you're gonna give us a deep dive because I know you're supposed to.
No. You
damn that loud ass sip.
30 years.
And you're gonna give us a deep dive because I know you're supposed to.
No. You gonna explain the fuck. You ain't gonna. Oh, I don't know. Where did he find a staple gun?
Hey, basically, there's a producer. And the producer is saying that Playboy Cardi during his extension took a bunch of deep stuff.
Who is the employee that sold him a staple gun?
We can talk about that tomorrow if y'all want. All right, so let's have a serious conversation now for a second.
Finally.
Designer.
You. I like that, which is why that whole, Jesus.
Wait, no. You're not gonna jump in on this one. Where did he find a staple gun?
Or something like that. Wow.
Okay.
Wale?
Why did he stomp like that? Listen to that.
Wale just told me yesterday that he can't wait to beat the brakes off of you.
Yo, who?
You!
Wale? Wale?
Yes!
Alright.
Wale!
Hey, listen.
Bruh.
Wale beating up shit, relax. The shit out of you.
Wale beating up shit, relax.
Wale just told me yesterday that he can't wait to beat the brakes off of you.
Yo, who?
You!
Wale? Wale?
Yes!
Alright.
Wale!
Hey, listen.
You!
I'd rather Wale than me. Alright?
Angel fucking Diaz. Where are you so academics can face you? Every time I kick his ass, the pundits like you would say, I'm only trying to promote an album. Joe Budden has never given a fuck about promotion, Angel Diaz. It ain't about the podcast. I care about rap. Nigga, you just wrong. Shut the fuck up and be wrong.
Bruh.
It's okay to be wrong. Somebody I don't care about dick riders like you who want to perpetuate shit to be in Drake's favor.
I'm not a Drake fan, though.
Then why'd you say that? For people that don't know hip-hop. For idiots like him who do not know hip-hop.
hip-hop. For idiots like him who do not know hip-hop.
Why come back?
I have a problem with that.
My point here is,
where did he find a staple gun? I be on Sunset, still go back to 58 to Stony. Cooked out my basement, got my tape, and got my homies blessed. I play the keys in my sleep, when the beast has a dream vacation. Say you ain't heard, I'll let you.
What's up, Los Angeles? Ladies and gentlemen, the reigning gentleman, 155-pound gentleman, the notorious gentleman, McGregor!
I couldn't hear anything that those motherfuckers said, but 20,000
gentlemen,
it's mind blown. I always said, what can I say? It's mind blown. I'm just enjoying it.
LA, we'd like to welcome the undefeated
gentlemen.
12-time world
gentlemen,
none other than Floyd Money Mayweather.
Damn.
Hard work, hard work, hard work, hard work. All work is what?
Hard work.
Why is 21 a number? All work is what?
Hard work.
Hey, he look good for us.
Gentlemen!
We talking about.
Gentlemen!
I don't. I don't. I'm gonna stop streaming. I don't even know why I started streaming. I'm gonna see y'all niggas tomorrow when I'm coherent.